Good evening from New York. I'm Chris Hayes. The Islamic State of Iraq and al-Sham, or ISIS, the militant Sunni group that now controls a wide swath of territory, spanning from Aleppo in Syria through northern Iraq, launched a global social media campaign today. All around the world, supporters of the group are tweeting with the hashtag, All Eyes on ISIS. And since their explosive growth and the chaos of the Syrian civil war, they have stretched their tentacles across the globe to draw in new recruits. For disaffected young Muslim men around the world, videos like this present the opportunity to join in a heroic romantic struggle.
I don't say things. When I write a statement, when I write something, and I wrote a statement and then I said something on the show, like, I don't do that unless I stand by every word.
Thinking today and observing Memorial Day that'll be happening tomorrow. I think it's interesting because it is, I think, very difficult to talk about the war dead and the fallen without invoking valor, without invoking the words heroes. Why do I feel so comfortable about the word hero? I feel uncomfortable about the word hero because it seems to me that it is so rhetorically proximate to justifications for more war. It seems to me that we marshal this word in a way that is problematic.
But it's these images that have really shocked the people of Iraq and threatened to plunge this country deeper into sectarian bloodshed. ISIS claims the photos show its fighters executing more than 1,700 men.
To join in a heroic romantic struggle.
I'm not going to say things I don't believe.
Is Steven a soy boy? Well, yes.
He's a soy boy.
Dairy can have many side effects. Try soy milk, 100% lactose free.
Soy boys.
So the Republicans this week were attacking Democratic Congresswoman-elect Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. And in their defense, they do that every week.
Soy boy.
I don't know why. She drives them nuts for some reason. AOC's argument was basically that the Electoral College unfairly diminishes the voting power of some Americans and therefore is incompatible with our basic democratic commitments. That was the argument.
Alexandra Ocasio-Cortez, I should say, writes, "It is well past time we eliminate the Electoral College, a shadow of slavery's power on America today that undermines our nation as a democratic republic."
AOC's argument was basically that the Electoral College unfairly diminishes the voting power of some Americans and
bullshit.
AOC calling it a scam, the Electoral College.
We're coming to you live from the Electoral College. Many votes here, as you can see. Very efficient way to choose leadership of the country. I can't think of any other way, can you?
Nearly every single Congress has tried to reform Electoral College since 1804. So this is how a loser cries, essentially.
Republicans flipped out. All right, they went after her very hard. Freshman Republican Congressman, a guy by the name of Dan Crenshaw from Texas, he tweeted at her that we live in a republic, not a democracy. You probably heard that before.
Soy boy.
And this is a quote, 51% doesn't get to boss around 49%. We'll talk a bit over it. Well, good. And this is a quote, 51% doesn't get to boss around 49%.
And they want to abolish the Electoral College. So what does this mean? It effectively means that 51% of the population could tell the other 49% of the population what to do.
And this is a quote, 51% doesn't get to boss around 49%.
Effectively means that 51% of the population could tell the other 49% of the population what to do.
51% doesn't get to boss around
41% of the population could tell the other 49% of the population what to do.
To be fair, it is not surprising the Republicans are defending the Electoral College, right? There's a very obvious reason for that. Since 1992, we have had 7 presidential elections. Republicans have won the popular vote one time. But they've gotten 3 presidents out of it.
Since 1992, we have had 7 presidential elections. Republicans have won the popular vote one time, but they've gotten 3 presidents out of it.
Which is a very sweet deal. And then the president's campaign took it to a totally new level. They sent this totally insane email. A fundraising email out to their list, basically accusing AOC, because she was advocating for majority rule, of attempting a coup to disenfranchise Republican conservatives. They explicitly say in this email, this is our country, not theirs. Basically accusing AOC, because she was advocating for majority rule, of attempting a coup.
Campaign email read, quote, "Socialist Rep. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez recently called for abolishing the Electoral College. Remind her that this country belongs to Americans from every zip code, not just the coastal elites and liberal mega donors. This is our country, not theirs."
Democrats would, rather change the rules so their elite friends in New York and California can regain their power,
Before that, I was thinking I could use me another 6 or 8 cans of that potted meat. You got any extra?
Democrats would, rather change the rules.
California Republicans continue losing seats they won on election night as new laws favored Democrat voters in the 2018 midterms.
Democrats would, rather change the rules so their elite friends in New York and California can regain their power.
As ballots continue being counted in California, Republicans continue losing seats they thought they'd won nearly a month after the election was over. California also has a unique system that permits vote harvesting, a tactic heavily favors Democratic voters.
What vote harvesting is a change in the rule book of how we do elections in the state of California. The Democrats saw that they were down 5 to 10 points, and they went out there and they grabbed massive amounts of vote-by-mail ballots and brought them in.
Weirdest thing about the Electoral College is the fact that if it wasn't specifically in the Constitution for the presidency, it would be unconstitutional.
Say what?
The Electoral College is the fact that if it wasn't specifically in the Constitution,
it would be unconstitutional.
You're so dumb. You are really dumb. For real.
I'm not going to say things I don't believe.
The real genesis of the Electoral College was the belief shared by a lot of the founders that ordinary people were dumb.
Obama, yes, I do. I love President Obama. And guess what? I voted for him. Do you want to know why I voted for him? Do you want to know why? Because he black. He black.
It was the belief shared by a lot of the founders that ordinary people were dumb and couldn't be trusted to elect a president.
Sorry, boy.
I'm voting for Obama because he's going to lower my taxes.
Actually, he has promised to raise taxes at your income level.
Huh? Are you working with a group? You've got a UAW sign right there.
Donald Trump has accused me of whatever. No, I do not. Yes, I am union. Union is standing.
Well, I also support Obama because he's against corporate bailouts.
That is also not true.
Huh?
I support Bernie Sanders 120%.
I'm supporting Obama because he black.
He black. Yes, I said it. I said it again. I voted for him because he was black.
I never thought this day would ever happen. I won't have to worry about putting gas in my car. I won't have to worry about paying my mortgage. You know, if I help him, he's going to help me.
You got Obama phone?
Yes, everybody in Cleveland, low minority, got Obama phone. Keep Obama in president, you know?
You're fucking a white male! You're a white man!
And he's gonna get the troops out of Afghanistan, right?
Also wrong.
Then what the fuck that nigga gonna do?
Wow.
What they do is they look at this map. Trump says this too. Right? You see this map? You've seen this map before? This is a map that Donald Trump loves.
Yeah!
Okay? But here's the thing. This is a map of land, not of human beings.
No shit, Sherlock.
It is, in fact, a map that is up in the White House. No, seriously, it's like the first thing they put up. In this map, this exact map, right? Hillary Clinton got 3 million more votes than Donald Trump. That one of the major political coalitions in American life doesn't want Americans, a majority of them, to run the country because they fear. They know, they suspect deep down that they are in the minority.
Please clap.
He's a soy boy.
It is now fairly clear the 2016 race for president will be fought between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump. Now, there are many people saying there is no way that Trump could beat Clinton head-to-head.
Soy boy.
It's almost over. No, it's amazing to be closing out this strong. The energy is really good. I was in Pennsylvania knocking on doors this weekend, and it really felt like there was history being made and people were excited. I think the greatest underreported story of 2016 is the super enthusiastic Hillary Clinton supporter. And tomorrow we get to be heard.
That is a great, we're going to see tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
One of the stories, so many narratives this election.
And so if Trump were to outperform previous Republican nominees in the Rust Belt states, Michigan, Pennsylvania, and Ohio, it would Michigan, Pennsylvania, and Ohio, it would totally change the electorate. And so you could see if he won Pennsylvania, Ohio, and Florida, he's likely to be our next president.
Yeah, but Florida, Pennsylvania, and Ohio, that is, I mean, winning all three of those, just to be clear, that's a heavy lift.
Well, in Pennsylvania has gone Democratic, I think, the last 6 presidential elections in a row. And because of the work that happened in 2008 during the primary, and for, you know, the work that's continued since, there's almost 1 million more registered Democrats than Republicans in Pennsylvania. So it's a very, very, very tall order for him to do that. But that is probably his most plausible path to 270.
So let's...